Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's session, you're going to learn about how to install and set up Jenkins in AWS EC2 Instance, and then how to integrate with Docker and make automatic build using Jenkins Pipeline. Now, it will be very easy session and follow till end. And if you didn't subscribe to the channel yet, do subscribe to the channel, like this video and share this video with others. And don't forget to click on the bell icon so that anytime I upload new video, you'll get notified. Okay. Now that you have did it, let's continue to the session. If you're logged into AWS, you will see this screen first. Search for AWS EC2. Then click on Launch Instance. See Launch Instance? There, select the first image, Amazon Linux 2 AMI. Select that. T2 instance will be enough for our demo. Review and launch. Go down. In the security group section, there is an edit security group option. Click on that and add port 8080 because Jenkins default run on port 8080. It is changeable, but in this session, you will go with the default options. Review and launch. All good. Click on the launch button. And then you will see option to either download an existing key pair or you can create a new key pair if you don't have any. Like give it a name and download the key pair and you can utilize that key pair. Since you already have one key, we'll go with that. Okay. Click on launch instances. It will take few seconds till the instance get ready state. Till then, just edit that name to Jenkins Master. Okay. And save it. Just make it Jenkins Master. Our instance is ready now. Let's SSH into this machine. Right click on it, click on connect, and then you'll see the option of, see, you all have other option also, but it's more better to have, you know, in the SSH client. It's more accessible. Okay, so click on this copy and let's connect with this instance. Let me make it big so you guys can see it. Yes. Okay, so we are now logged into the EC2 instance. Now clear it up. Let's first update all the dependency list. So yum update. And we'll, okay, there's nothing to update. Now we'll follow one article, okay, where I've already mentioned all the steps and we'll follow the exact same step so that you can also follow the same when you're trying all by yourself, okay. Now here, first is to install Jenkins, okay. So first link, installing Jenkins, click on that. Go down. See, we have already covered all these steps, isn't it? Now go down and down, you will see option to install. Okay, this is the one. We already actually run it, but again, just for showing you, I will just run it again. Okay, nothing updated. Now add Jenkins repo into the repository list. Let's do it. Done. Now import the key. Done. Now let's update the dependency packages. Okay, do yes. Now package is updated. Now install Jenkins. Sudo yum install Jenkins. And you might notice is that we are also installing Java, because to run Jenkins, Java is also required. Okay. So it will install within few seconds. Let's wait for that. So Jenkins done. Now just reload the system daemon. Done. Now run sudo systemctl start Jenkins and check that Jenkins working fine or not using sudo systemctl system control status Jenkins. Okay. Run it and Jenkins running fine. Now to configure it, let's open the IP. Just click on the instance ID and then we'll go to the networking. We'll find it the public IP. Okay, copy that and then load it in the browser with port 8080. It will open the Jenkins dashboard for you. But before going to further to the directly Jenkins dashboard, it will ask you for the administrative password. Okay. See, this is the one, unlock Jenkins. For that, we need this password. We can simply go to our system, do sudo cat and then this, and this is our password, paste it here and continue. Now it's asking for to install suggested plugins And I will suggest you to install the SSH plugin because these are the required plugins and it will helpful to you. Okay, so click on that. And you'll see it's getting started, it's installing all the all the SSH plugins. And within few seconds, all will be installed and we'll be able to use the Jenkins dashboard. Okay, so wait for that. So all plugins now installed. You might see it here. Now it's asking to create the first admin user. So give it that username, password, confirm the password, then full name, Sandip Das, and my email ID, contact sandeepdas.in. Okay, save and continue. And it says instance configuration is Jenkins URL. You already know, we accessed it. Now start, click on start using Jenkins. And now our Jenkins is ready to use. Now let's follow our article to see what next to do. Now install Docker. So to install Docker, click on this link and go down. You will see the steps to install Jenkins. Now go down and we'll see option to install Docker on EC2 instance. So run these commands. Okay. Update the packages. Now install Docker. Now if you're using Amazon Linux 2, you run this command. If you're using old version of AMI, the old Linux AMI, then use the old command. Okay, it's up to you. Now let's do it. Now the Docker is getting installed. Let's wait for it to complete. So Docker is installed now. Now let's start the Docker. Docker start. Let's check the, now add the EC2 in the Docker group. It's done. Now sudo service docker status and Docker is running fine. Now let's go back to our article and make sure that add Jenkins in the Docker group. Okay, then restart the Jenkins. So you will see it's restarting. Now next is reload the system daemon. Okay, now let's restart the Docker. Sudo service docker restart. Okay, and you will see Docker is restarted. Now go down and now we have to install the Docker plugins. Okay, now to install the Docker required Docker plugins, we should go click on the manage Jenkins and then there's a manage plugin option. Click on that and then click on the available tab and there search for Docker. We will require two plugins. One is the Docker plugin and another is the Docker pipeline plugin. Let's install that without restart. So click on install without restart. And it's installing all that. Now are all the plugins installed. Click go to dashboard. Here. Now let's follow the next steps. So our plugins installed. Now let's install the Git. Okay. So use sudo yum install git. Click yes. Okay, now the Git is also installed. Now let's go to the next step. Let's create an ECR repo because ultimately you're making Docker build and you have to store that image somewhere, right, in the cloud. So let's go to the Amazon console. So let's go to the main screen and there search for ECR, that is Elastic Container Registry. Click on that and let's call it Jenkins Pipeline build demo. Okay, now and go down, create the repository. This is the one, Jenkins pipeline build demo. Click on that. Now if you click on the view push command, you will see all the command required to push the image, like make build the image and push to the ECR. Okay, so remember that part, you just have a look at that. Now go down. Now after we have created the ECR repo, we have to create one IAM role and give them access of the container registry and attach it this instance where we are hosting the Jenkins server. Okay, now let's go back and again let's open AWS console. There go for IAM service and here in the roles click on create role, select EC2 and then click on next permissions, then here search for registry. See AWS EC2 container registry full access, select that. Next tags. No need to give any tags. If you want to, you can give, but we don't need. You can call it ECR registry full access EC2. Okay, ECR registry full access EC2. Now click on create role. And you can call it ECR registry full access EC2. This is the role we have created. Now go to EC2. Click on running instance. We have only one instance running. Now once we have come into the EC2 running instances, we have our Jenkins master node running where you are hosting the this Jenkins dashboard. There, right click on it, the instance name, and then go to the security part. There's an option called modified IAM role. Click on that. In the choose IAM role, search for the role you have created. So ECR registry full access EC2. Save it. Okay, so you're done with that. Now we attach to the IAM, we are done with, but let's verify that it's working fine or not. So go to the ECR. And this is the like logging. This is the code to log in and check that ECR working access is fine or not. So let's go and run it. I know why it's happening. So simply just have to mention sudo if sudo. Okay, then run it. Okay, login succeeded. Now come to the article and says the next step is to creating the Jenkins pipeline. So for that we need to create the pipeline. Okay, with your project name. So click on dashboard, and then there is an option called new item in the dashboard. Click on that, and it will ask you for the name. Let's call it Jenkins Docker Build Pipeline. Now I'm giving like this. You can give any name as you prefer. There's no problem on that part. Click the pipeline. Now okay. Okay, it will load the screen. Now GitHub project. So in this project URL, we need to give the project URL, right? For that, I have one project that is I'm utilizing for all the demos. We have this simple Node application running that you are running a CI/CD app version 1 and the status. Like this is a simple one. And the important part here is the Docker file, because using a Docker file, we will build the image, right? So here what you're doing, we are using the base image as Node 14. Then you are setting up the work directory. Then you're copying all the packages list. Then installing all the packages. After the package installation done, you are copying all the files, and you are exposing port 3000, and then you are running the application when you execute the Docker image. Okay, that's all we are doing here. Okay, now come back here in the project URL. Simply go to the project and run git remote minus v, or you already know might be what is your project GitHub URL. Give it here. Now go down in the build triggers, click on the poll SCM. And give like this 5-star separated by space. What means is it will run each minute. For now, it's okay. But if you want to see or know how to automatically do it, check in the below description. There is a video available where I have covered everything already. So you can follow that one. Okay. Now go down and there's a pipeline script. Now again, go back to the article and you will see this pipeline script. Let's copy that. I will explain very easily one by one what it is does and what it's doing, so you can also follow up and do the same. Paste that here. So first, in the environment, you are mentioning the account ID, the default region, the image repo name, the image tag, and the repository UI. Why I'm mentioning? Because if you come to our ECR, you can see the command list. First, you have to login, and here you are logging. We are mentioning the region. We are mentioning the username, password, then the account ID. Then the repo name. Here we are building the image where you need the names. Then we are pushing to the image repo where again we need the repo name and the tag name. So we need all this command. That's why the pipeline, we are mentioning all the environment variables, so we can reuse it as much as we want. So let's fill one by one so you'll understand why this is required. In the account ID, again come to the ECR, you'll find this is the account ID. Let's paste it. And then the default region, you can copy from top also, or if you want, you can copy from here as well. See, in the middle, this is the region name. Okay, copy that. Remove any command, like if you have any command, like copy it from here, remove the command. Then image repo name, come back here. At the very end, we have this image repo name, right? Or you know, you can in the top also, you can copy it. It's up to you. Image tag, let's give it latest. Now you see, we are utilizing all these environment variable as repository UI, except the image tag. I'll show you why you're utilizing that. But for now, is that repository URI is the account ID, then the ECR, Docker ECR, then the region name, and then Amazon AWS, and the image repo name that is here. Okay, that's how we mapped it. Now the first step is to log in ECR and check that's working fine or not. Okay, and here we are utilizing the environment variables what you defined here. So first step is to log into ECR where we are running a shell script, AWS ECR get login password, region, then Docker region, username, and all the command that is required to do the login. As mentioned here, we are doing the same thing here in the first. Then we are cloning the Git, because in the Git we have the source repo using what we can make the build. So that is, we require that. Even the Docker file is there also, and we need to use the Docker file to make the Docker image. Okay, that we are doing now. If you are confused about how to generate this script, normally you can just replace this, but if you have a username, password and all, so simply go to pipeline syntax, go to new tab and look for checkout. Okay, in this checkout, see, it's asking SCM, and there give the, like, paste the repository URI like this. And if you have any username, password, mention it here, add the credentials and generate it. Like after you're done with adding the, you know, this is public repo, but for private, you need to give the username, password. Then click on the generate script and you will find this script and simply copy that like I did here. See, I just simply copied that. Now the next stage is to building the image. For that, you're utilizing the, you remember the plugin you have installed, that plugin you're utilizing here, Docker image, Docker build, then the image repo name that you have mentioned in the environment variables, and the tag name that also we have mentioned here. That's why we are utilizing the Docker image, that image tag. Now in the final stage, we are pushing that, we are tagging the Docker local build with the remote repo. Okay, and then we are pushing the image to the ECR. That's all we are doing here. Okay, now let's click on apply and then click on save. Okay, doing that, now we can simply run build now and see how the build goes. Okay, and again, if you miss any step, if you want to check anything, you can always come to this article and follow the step. Let's come back to our build. So first is done, the logging is success. You can simply click on the build and you can see the cloning also done, 4 seconds. Now the building of image happening. Let's click on this build number in the left side. I just clicked and that will load. You can click on the console output and in this you can see what is happening behind the scene. You can see that Docker login happened, then the source pulled, then the Docker build is getting generated, is like pulling the base image node 14, then pulling all the changes, and then now it's making the build, like copying the package JSON, running the installation package. This will happen, and after all this done, you will see at the final end, it will simply upload the file to ECR. So let's wait for that, then I will show you the image is updating fine or not. Okay, okay, so now image is pushed. You can see it here. Okay, now let's come back to the ECR and just do a refresh. The image is here. That's how easy it is to integrate and all. Now if you like this session and you find it very useful, please do like this video, share with others, subscribe the channel, and don't forget to click on the bell icon. Okay, if you face any issues, simply reach out to me via LinkedIn or the comments, whatever method you think is good, and follow this article link in the description. Again, follow it. Thank you everyone for watching this video till the end. Again, if any issue, reach out to me by comments or via LinkedIn, anywhere you want, you can reach out. Have a nice day ahead and do try it yourself. Okay, bye bye.